Hey guys.
Hello, me bitch.
Today's video is going to be a very casual video. I have some new makeup here that I haven't tried. I was gonna make an entire video on just this palette. This is the Honey palette from Colourpop, and it is the most sexual thing I've ever seen. I have never felt so sexually attracted to a palette before. As soon as I saw the pictures of this palette, I knew that I had to have it. I posted a video a little while back where I had kind of a yellowy, summery eye, and that's just my vibe this summer. I am super feeling the summer yellow eyes. So yeah, I bought this pretty much right away, because God knows they weren't gonna send it to me. I feel like I've been gone for so long from this channel, but really what it is that I've been working on a video that's taking me fucking forever. I'm gonna show you a little sneak peek of what I put on Instagram, but basically this is what my beauty section in my closet looks like. And I'm filming an entire video on decluttering and reorganizing it, and it is taking forever. Who would have thunk? So yeah, that's why I've been gone for so long. So I wanted to film some videos in the meanwhile, because I thought that was gonna be the video I was gonna come back with, and turns out, just kidding, it's gonna take me 7 years to fix this closet. Okay, I'm rambling again. What's new? Let's just get started. Okay, so I'm gonna start by priming my face, and I have two things here that are completely new to me. This is something that I got, and I genuinely have no idea what it is. What are you? I don't even know how to read the name. I'm gonna put in like a little video of it, but there's so many fucking words on this bottle, and there's like overlapping the words that are on the bottle, so it's like really impossible to read what the fuck this is. And then when you finally do read it, it just says Coreflex Essential Liquid. I know this is a Korean skincare product, and so obviously it's not, you know, English isn't their first language, but I genuinely struggle with understanding what this is for. There's no directions. However, when I spray it on my hand, the vibe that I get is that it's some sort of hydrating spray. If anybody knows what this is, I probably sound like an idiot. Like, can you just let me know what this is? I genuinely do not understand. But I'm gonna be spraying that on top of this primer. And this is the Tula Skincare Face Filter Blurring and Moisturizing Primer. I did a brand deal a while back with Tula on Instagram, and I genuinely still use their products. There are some that I really enjoy, and there are some that I don't care for. So I'm interested to see how this is gonna work. I poured it out on my hand, and it's interesting. Oh, I don't like this shot. Oh, gross. Oh, Jesus. Ew. And just like that, we are demonetized. Great. I want to try to show you what this does in the least disgusting way possible, but it's like orange. Can you see that? It like turns brown, but it has like an orange tint to it. So I'm really confused. But however, as far as how it feels, it doesn't feel super hydrating, if that makes sense. You know the things that you can feel on your skin and you're like, ooh, that's like really hydrating, it's gonna just soak right into my skin. That's not the vibe I'm getting here. That being said, I would have to wait and see until I put on my foundation to see how it works. But anyway, I'm gonna spray some of this essential liquid, whatever that means, on top. Oh my God, it smells like my abuela. It for sure smells like old lady perfume, but like watered down. So it's not like you're spraying the perfume directly on your face, but like if you mix that perfume with water, that's what you're spraying on your face. Goes away pretty quick though, it's not like lingering, so all right. Now for the main attraction. This is, I'm so excited right now. It comes with a mirror. It's one of their plastic palettes. I honestly prefer their cardboard palettes. I don't know why, it's just a thing. There are definitely a few formulas here. You have shimmers, and then you have a pressed glitter, it looks like. And then you have your matte shades. So I'm super, super happy with this palette, and I cannot wait to try it. Okay, let's do it. Wow, I just got a view of myself in the viewfinder. Do you see how glowy my skin is right now? What the fuck? See, this is why I shouldn't have tried two primers. Jesse, you're such a freaking noob. Because if you try two primers and it's amazing, which one is it? Which one did it? Well, either way, I am just completely shocked at how shiny, glowy, amazing my skin looks right now. What is happening? Okay, I'm gonna go in with my Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in Eden. Jesus, I cannot stop looking at my skin. I am shining. So I sprayed the spray on my hand, and my hand looks the same, like it looks all glowy. So I'm gonna have to say it's the spray that's doing this glowiness. And I cannot believe that I've had this spray forever, and I didn't know it was like a hydrating glowing spray. Hello, I love those types of things. By the way, I've been blending my eyeshadow primer with a brush, and wow, so much faster, so much easier. Wish I would have thought of this 5 years ago, but you know, that's how I work. By the way, if you are new here, this is not an eye booger. Anytime I get new subscribers, I always get a bunch of people saying, hey, did you notice you have a giant eye booger? It's like, oh no, I didn't notice that. It's a skin tag, okay? And leave me alone, she's here to stay. I'm gonna set my eyeshadow primer with this cream shade. For a while there, I was going with the whole thing where you don't set your eyeshadow primer potion, you just start applying your transition shade while it's wet, and I really did not enjoy that. I personally find it so much harder to blend, and unless I'm doing a shade where it like needs to show up, which I guess yellow would be considered one of those shades. But whatever, I'd rather something go on diffused, and then I just keep adding, oh my god, I look crazy. Oh. Oh Jesus. Anyway, I don't know what I was talking about. Let's move on. So, which shade are we gonna go in with? I feel like I wanna start with this shade right here. It's called Stinger, and I just feel like it's a little bit more toned down than the rest of the shades. I'm gonna add the rest of the shades, but just little by little. Ooh, that's like a neon yellow. Whoa, that's not what I was expecting. It does not look neon yellow in the pan. What the? What a ham? It looks like a much more toned down yellow when you're looking at it in the palette, and then when you apply it, it's like a super, super neon-y type shade. Wow, okay, well, I'm still into it. I wanted to get this palette right away, but it was sold out super quick, and I'm not sure if it's like for real sold out or the fake sold out that they do to try to sell more. But either way, they didn't let me buy it by itself, so I had to buy it in a queen, I think it was called Queen Bee package, and it came with these two eyeliners, which I'm not mad at. I definitely don't have a yellow eyeliner like that, so whatever. But I just hate that they do that, because it's like, I know they have more palettes. They're just eating shit. They're trying to get us to buy more, and it's working. I'm just going to blend that. I'm gonna start putting the brushes that I'm using in the video, because I keep getting questions on what brushes I'm using, and rather than like listing them in the description and then you have to like see which one I'm using, you know what I'm talking about. I'm just gonna write them on the screen. Okay, next I'm gonna go into a much more bright shade, which I'm nervous about, because this one I didn't think was gonna be that bright, and it really was. This one is called Sweet Spot. I feel like it's hard for you to see all the shades because the lights are kind of like drowning them out, but this one looks really bright. Oh shit. Oh wow. What is happening? This is so much more neon than I thought it was gonna be like. I don't know why I thought it was just gonna be these soft little yellow shades. I'm not mad at it. That's not what I'm trying to say, but like, I just, wow. All right, so actually I'm going, it's a little too yellow, okay? I know I love yellow, but Jesus. Okay, so I'm gonna go into this color right here. It's called Totally Buggin'. It's more of an orangey shade than a yellowy shade. So I'm gonna grab that and just try to tone everything down a little bit. Plus, I love mixing peachy shades with yellow. I feel like it gives a really pretty kind of like sunset-y look. So I'm just gonna bring this and try to make this a little bit less crazy yellow, even though it's yellow, bitch. There's no denying it. And then I'm just gonna go in and blend everything. It honestly goes on pretty blended, so there's not much that I need to do, but I like to do this in every step after adding every single shade, because in the end it makes it look a lot more put together. The next color I'm gonna go into is Oh Behave. It's definitely still yellow, but it's more of a mustardy type of yellow, so I'm gonna grab that. I'm not cleaning off my brush in between these steps. Oh shit, that's really yellow. Oh fuck. I'm just gonna put a little bit here so that it can match, but then I'm gonna abort mission. Don't want it to be that yellow. I feel like we're getting a little crazy here. Okay, then I'm gonna grab a different brush and take this color here. That's called Buzzkill. When I did my yellowish look on, I forgot what video it was, honestly, but when I did that, I also used a more cool tone brown, because this is definitely more on the cool tone side. I feel like it deepens the yellow without like disturbing the color too much. So I'm really happy that they put a cool tone brown in here. I feel like it's the perfect thing to deepen up a crease of a yellow eye. Oh my god, I love this color. I love when it's mixed in. I feel like it makes everything, like, it just grounds everything. It just gives more depth. Like, honestly, if you just have a yellow eye like this without something to deepen it, it looks a little weird. Wow, I love this cool tone shade. I feel like it's so perfect. I don't think I have a shade that's this kind of brown, because it's not too light. It's not like a transition shade necessarily, but it's also not too dark. I remember the cool tone shade that I used, I had to like lightly tap it and blend it in, but this is like really, really easy to use. Colourpop, don't you see me over here? Sucking your dick. Send me some shit. I'm just gonna blend that out. You guys asked me to keep in my blending, so I'm gonna do that. Most of the time I'll probably just speed it up, but I will show you how much I blend it, because otherwise it may be difficult if you're trying to follow this to know how long you have to do it for. As I'm blending it out, it's definitely getting a little patchy, that brown, which is weird because it was like looking so good a second ago and now it's looking patchy. Okay, I'm gonna go in with a mixture of these two shades and I'm gonna try to run this over where the brown is so that I can get a more blended look, because I don't know, for some reason when I started blending it out, it looked a little bit patchy. But that could just be because it's a cool tone shade. I've said it a billion times on this channel. Cool tone shades are from the devil. They are so difficult to blend out for no fucking reason and usually look like mud. So this isn't that bad considering it is cool toned. Okay, honestly, I'm not in the mood to blend that much today, so that's about all we're gonna do. And I'm gonna keep this look very simple. So I'm just gonna cut the crease already. This is pretty much what I'm gonna do on the eyes. This is my Born This Way concealer. And I'm gonna use this Luxie brush that just came in this month's BoxyCharm. Was it this month's or last month's? No, this month. Sometimes I don't know because my BoxyCharm gets in so late. I get my BoxyCharm like almost when the month's over. Does anybody know how I can change that? They don't send it to me, I buy it. Obviously, I don't need to say that. Everyone knows. I don't know. I want to switch the dates. I want to get it first. By the time I get it, everyone's made a fucking video about it and I already know what's in the box. Anyway, I'm just cutting the crease a little bit. I don't like for it to go too high. And then I'm going to do the same on the other side. Cover up my little skin tag. You know, she likes to look fly too. My goodness, guys, my brain stresses over the dumbest shit. And I mean, I know that people, like, a lot of people can relate to that, but like, I'm being serious. Like, it really fucking stresses over the dumbest shit. I've been debating for months now on whether or not I should include sped up clips in my videos where I'm doing my makeup. Like, you know how most beauty gurus, they'll be like, I'm gonna put on my foundation, and then boom, it like goes into music and they're just putting on their foundation really quick. I've debated doing that for months. That's what's plagued my brain for months. It's like, just do it or don't do it, bitch. Relax, Jesus. Oh my God. I hate when people tell me to relax. I feel like I was the friend in high school where everyone was always like, Jessie, chill out. And I was like, if you were inside of my brain, you would understand. Jessie doesn't have a chill out mode. Jessie only has freak out mode. Even when Jessie's chill, she's still freaking out. I've literally been on vacation, on a boat, in the ocean, and then I'm just like, what if I die? Like right now, what if I just died? Anyway, I don't know what I was talking about. You know, always gets depressing somehow. Okay, so what I wanna do is I wanna grab this shade right here called Sunburst, and I wanna put that in my inner corner here. Oh. Hello. Wow. Fuck. That is such a pretty shade. Holy shit. Is that like the prettiest shimmer that ColourPop has ever come out with? What even is this color? Sorry, I need a moment. Now I just want to put that over my whole lid. Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Hello? Wow, that is such a pretty shade. It is literally so unique. It is a metallic, like, canary shade with almost, like, blue reflex in it. Blue silver reflex in it. I can't deal with it. Like, that is the prettiest shade I've ever seen. I've said it many times on my channel, but, like, it's hard nowadays to find an actually unique shade when people are coming out with so much shit every day, but that is unique. Anyway, now I'm gonna take some NYX Glitter Primer that I'm 100% sure is expired. Says the shelf life is 6 months, and I got this 5 years ago. Here we go. Hope we don't get an infection. I'm just gonna grab a little bit of that because I do want to use the pressed glitter in the palette, even though I'm really tempted to just put that yellow shade all over my lid. But I'm gonna go ahead and use the glitter here in the middle of my eye. And I'm just gonna pick it up with my finger. It does look pretty messy. Oh, sweetheart, you're beautiful. I'm gonna bring a little bit of the glitter in like that. That was a mistake. Okay, shit. This glitter, I'm not gonna lie, is super crumbly, but I feel like that's very, very common with pressed glitters. Have you guys seen all of those glitter palettes on Instagram? I feel like it's a good idea, but then it's just like messy. Like, I feel like they could have just sold this in a little bottle. I mean, that would have been messy too. Glitter's just fucking messy. Dude, I love that. I know it's a bit much. Obviously, it's definitely a bit much. But I think it's so pretty. I love it. You're my new best friend. Okay, so for eyeliner, I'm actually gonna be using the ColourPop liquid liner. This is their BFF liner, I'm pretty sure. When I did my video on the intense blue eyeliner look that I do, a lot of you guys suggested to me the ColourPop BFF line because they do have vibrant colors. But I'm gonna go ahead and say this right now. This is not one of their vibrant colors. When I went to look, they had no blue that was similar to the NYX one. This blue is more of a navy blue, and that's pretty much all they have. So I'm gonna be using this navy blue. I don't know color wheels. I don't know if blue and yellow go together, but something tells me they might. I'm just gonna do a wing eyeliner and I'm gonna speed this up with music. Future Jessie, don't stress it. Just do it. It's no big deal. Nobody even cares. We'll be right back. Okay, so don't judge me. Don't you judge me. I ended up doing a very thick wing, and it has everything to do with the fact that I messed up really bad. This liner is not the hardest to work with. It's a felt tip liner, but it is very liquidy, if that makes sense. However, like once I did this eye was much easier. I just wasn't used to the formula, so then I messed up this eye, but then this eye I had to mess up so that it could match. Overall, it's definitely thicker than I planned for, but we're here, we're dealing with it. Now that we're on this train, I think I'm just gonna speed up me doing my foundation because I feel like usually what I do is I just go off camera and I'll do things, but I'd rather you see me do them. Even if I'm not, I can't find my fucking foundation. Where is it? Oh, here it is, it's on the floor. What a surprise. I don't know, let me know what you guys prefer. Do you prefer the sped up music and like seeing me do things and not going off camera to do things? Or do you prefer me going off camera and then just coming back when I'm doing something new? Why do you choose until I have to work to be so needy? But anyway, I'm gonna put on my foundation and my concealer and then I'm gonna set it. But first, I'm gonna tell you what I'm using. This is a Tarte Amazonian Clay Full Coverage Foundation. I'm gonna use my Makeup Forever HD foundation to blend it down my neck because it's way too dark for me, and that's how I cheat it without having to buy a new shade. I just put a lighter shade here and blend it. And then I'm gonna use my Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer and my Laura Mercier Setting Powder. All of this is gonna be in the description anyway, but I'm just explaining it. Anyway, I'm gonna go do that. I'll be right back. Okay, I don't know what's happening right now. So I sprayed this because I didn't feel like getting my Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. It's in my closet and it's right there, but I don't feel like getting it. And although when I was powdering my skin, I did realize that there was glitter everywhere. I mean, some of it is obviously chunky yellow glitter that is like really, really thick, and that's from my eyes, which is really annoying. I feel like if you put glitter glue on, it should stick. And if it was one or two little specks of glitter, I would be okay with it, but it's so many of them and they really, really show through my foundation. And that's really disappointing. I feel like next time, obviously I'll just put more glitter glue, but like, Jesus. So I don't know what's happening. I'm very upset. Anyway, let's just finish off the eyes. I'm probably just gonna use this one, and this one. For the bottom, I usually just include some, if not all, of the shades that I put on top, just so that it looks cohesive. I do have to say, I didn't really share my thoughts on the eyeliner color. I just kind of commented on the formula. The eyeliner color is super underwhelming. It's like slightly teal. Like you can barely tell that it's, you know, got color to it. It just kind of looks black, which is not really what I wanted. Even though maybe a blue would have clashed too much, so it works better, I guess, but it's just, you can't really tell. I feel like they should come out with a much more vibrant blue. This is like the only blue option they have, and I'm not feeling it. Just gonna grab that darker cool tone shade and just deepen this up. I'm really not feeling how my wings came out today. I'm not ready to fly, bitch. I'm gonna grab some of that beautiful shade that we used on the inner corner of our lid, the Sunburst color, and I'm just gonna use that as the inner corner highlight. I mean, actually, it's not as reflective as I want, like not as highlighting as I want, so I'm just gonna grab my favorite highlight ever, which is Ofra's Rodeo Drive, and I'm just gonna put that on top of Sunburst just to add like some reflectiveness to it. Before I put on my lashes, I'm going to grab the BFF liner and just kind of run over the top here. I'm gonna run over it again once I have lashes on, but I like to just like make sure that everything looks good before I do that, because once you have lashes on, it's so much harder to see what you're doing. Usually they're blocking the way. Oh my god, I'm sweating so bad. I have to turn off the air to do these videos, and my titties are like a swamp. You didn't need to know that, but now you do, so what are you gonna do about it? All right, so now I'm gonna put on my lashes that are honestly, where'd they go? Oh no, those are the only pairs of lashes I have. Where do they go? Oh my gosh, no, for real, where'd they go? Oh no. Like, where could they have gone? You know, there's only so many places. I genuinely don't understand why my life is like this. All right, well, I can't find my lashes. So. However, I actually found some other lashes. The reason why I wasn't gonna use these is because I don't really like these. They're just a little bit more pointy and just a little more dramatic than I was gonna go for, but okay, here we are. I'm gonna do my lashes and my eyebrows on camera, but sped up again, because I feel like those are things that I take a lot of like focus on. Like it takes me a lot of, you know, zoning in and just focusing. So I won't be, you know, much use on camera because I will be too busy being focused. Anywho, I will have the style of these down below and my eyebrow products and all of that. So let's do this. Okay, so I'm genuinely so confused as to what's happening. I'm gonna rip these lashes off. I hate them. I hate everything about them. I just can't do it. But I thought, I was like, okay, I had my lashes on this table that I have right next to me. They couldn't have gone far. I decided to just turn the camera off and go and look for them, and I could not find them anywhere. I swear to you, I checked my ass. Anywho, I found these lashes, which are literally so old. They've been sitting by my sink for months. I don't know what kind of bacteria has built up on here. They look crusty. Really gross, but here we go, because I would rather get an eye infection than wear those lashes. Let's try this again. Okay, so the lashes could have been way worse, honestly. I mean, this one's definitely janky. It's holding on for dear life, but it's better than the other lashes, so. I'm gonna be mixing these two creme gel liners from Colourpop. I'm pretty sure these were already created, and then they kind of threw it in a bundle for the collection, but I could be wrong. This one is in the color Punch, and this one is Exit. So I'm actually gonna put both of them on and make like a baby yellow. I should have done this before mascara, but I honestly forgot. Oh wow, that's really pigmented. I mean, white eyeliners usually are, but. Shit! Leave it to me. Leave it to me to fuck up at the last second. Okay, and now I'm just gonna grab a little bit of the Punch color and see if I can like do like a little mix with that. Yeah, when you put it on top of a white, it kind of comes out to be a very similar color to what I have underneath. So I really like that. Sorry, I know I'm putting it on all weird because I only have one hand to do it and it's probably cringy to watch. But anyway, these are really, really creamy. I had never used them before. For lips, I'm gonna mix these two colors. These are something that I've never used before. Like, I probably opened this bottle, but I don't think I've actually ever put them on. Not these shades anyway. This is the Tartist lip paint. This one's in Bestie and this one is in Home Slice. I don't want the lips to be too cool tone or too warm, so I'm just gonna put a little bit of both. This formula is so dry and honestly, I don't love it, but I wanted to include something that I haven't really used on camera before, so that's why I'm using this. It's a pretty thin formula when you're putting it on, but it just gets so dry. I'm just gonna dot the Bestie shade on, the more cool tone one. Oh my god, that other shade is so dry already. I just put it on and it's hard to like mix them together. Look at this. Do you see that? It just like gets so weird. Honestly, I'll probably just wipe this off and then put a more me shade after this, but I wanted to use something new. Not new like, oh, it just came out, but new to me. Oh my god, my lips are like the Sahara Desert. Okay, so I have two actual new glosses that came out. Well, this, I don't know if it counts. This is the Alamad Cosmetics Mother of Pearl gloss. This is a limited edition summer thing and they don't have this anymore, but it just came in the BoxyCharm, so I have that. And then I also have this Ofra lip gloss in Sunshine. These are part of like the new glosses that they just launched, and this Sunshine color is pretty much clear with just a little bit of like glitter in it, but I feel like I want to use the Alamad one because I have never used it, surprisingly, and it just looks like it's really gonna make this kind of weird lip color maybe look a lot better because it actually has color to it. So I'm gonna apply this gloss on top. Oh my god.
I really like how these smell. It smells like pineapples. I feel like that's so unique. Like, I never smell anything other than like vanilla lip glosses.
Okay, so I definitely hate the colors that I put underneath. Like, I feel like I needed a more peachy color, but you know what? It is what it is. That's what's on my lip.
I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Sunstalk'r Bronzer in Shady Biz. This is just, ugh, I can't rave about this enough. I know I never shut up about this, but I rarely find a bronzer that is like just so easy to blend. Like, I feel like almost every bronzer, if you don't work with it, it's just a little patchy, but like this is not patchy at all. Even when my hair gets in here and I'm pretty much just blending my hair into my cheek, still not patchy. After I do my bronzer, you guys know the drill, I always grab like either powder or maybe not even powder, but at least a brush and just kind of blend it up. I'm not even looking. I don't care anymore.
I feel like this is a stage of makeup where I start to like just decline. Like, I just slowly start giving up. I begin every look with so much confidence and hope for the future, and then I get to the future and I'm like, uh-uh, bitch, no thank you.
So I usually end up with like a really cool eye look, and then my face makeup is just like there.
I'm applying the Burt's Bees blush in Toasted Cinnamon. This is a color I wear every single day. I love it so much. I feel like this is such a me shade. Like, I always have worn shades just like this, except the ones that I've worn in the past, like the Rockateur blush from Benefit and things like that, they usually have like a glow to it. And this doesn't really have a glow. It's more of a matte blush, which I really like because sometimes I go overboard with the glowy ones. But I just love how it looks. It looks like it's part of your bronzer. For highlight, I'm gonna be applying my favorite highlight, like I already mentioned when I was putting it on my eyes. This is Ofra's Rodeo Drive highlight. This is their like old packaging. I will forever and always go back to this highlighter. I might stray a little bit, you know, like sometimes I'll just get into another highlighter, but I always come back. It's the perfect amount of golden and pink. What the fuck?
Ew.
I want to see if you guys can see that, but my pores on my nose are so pronounced, so ginormous, and it wasn't just a highlight that did that. Like, it's also around here. Like, it just looks really not great. I'm really not sure if you can tell.
That's why it's bad to try two primers, because I don't know which one did that, but I know it's one of these two, because everything else I use every day, and this has never happened. But yeah, that's it for today's video. I didn't want to just do a video solely on the eyeshadow palette, so I decided to throw a few things in there, but I know most of these things you've seen before. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was all over the place. It is what it is. That's my life. That's what you're here for. That's what you're gonna get on this channel.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you're new here, and I'll see you next time. Bye!